Hey everyone, Emoji Movie Channel here, and I'm here to review another movie. Today we'll be talking about the Sony Pictures animation film, The Mitchells vs. the Machines. Now, I wasn't really all that excited for this movie. The first trailer was okay, but it didn't really hook me, and the second trailer was interesting, but I still had some doubts about the film. Then again, I did like the animation style, and Phil Lord and Chris Miller are great filmmakers, so it had potential. And yeah, this movie is great. You know I love the movie Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse, and this movie has a lot of similar positives to that one. My biggest concern when I saw the trailer was the whole plot switch, and I didn't think it would work out well in the movie. But to my surprise, it actually makes the movie a lot more interesting. The story itself is just your standard road trip plot, which can be fun if in the right hands. But what they do to make this plot more interesting is they combine it with a sci-fi adventure, and wow, it makes the movie so much fun. These things mesh together perfectly, and they make a pretty exciting and original story. I thought they set up the whole robot uprising thing and the main characters in the movie really well. Sure, this movie does start with a lot of exposition, which I'm usually not a big fan of, but just like Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse, it uses this in a creative way. It's not just giving plot details for the sake of giving plot details. It really helps you get invested in the main character and know what she's like. Speaking of the main character, the way she's written is great. Katie is a typical teenager who's different, but I think they did a really good job of showing that. In both the exposition scenes I mentioned and whenever she's just talking to her family, it just feels so natural. I feel this makes the movie much more engaging as a result. I mean, sure, these character arcs can be a bit predictable since we've seen them before, but these character interactions just make it all the more fun. The bond between Katie and her dad is really engaging because even though we can see where both characters are coming from, the movie isn't really telling us to side with either one. What both characters are like is established early on, and we're able to see them grow throughout the entire movie. Although they did shove in this forced drama liar reveal thing, it does make sense in the context of Katie's character, but I feel the movie already had enough conflict. I also like how Katie and her dad are given pretty much equal amounts of screen time, and they both grow to appreciate each other more. There are these really wholesome scenes where they both understand what each other's motivations are, and it just makes sense. And like I said, the dialogue isn't trying to force in the character development, it just feels very natural. That may be part of the reason why this movie is so funny. Like I said, Phil Lord and Chris Miller worked on it, and it definitely has their special humor. We have those great dialogue scenes which are just funny because of how well the characters work off each other, and the movie knows when to go over the top. A lot of the comedy just has this weird, unpredictable sense of humor, and yeah, it really works. The movie knows when to have what tone, and it uses those tones very well. There are also points in the movie where you think you know where a joke is going, but then it does something much more hilarious with it. This can also apply to entire scenes as well. There's this villain confrontation scene with Katie and Pal where Katie gives this big speech, kind of like this scene from the Lego movie, and what they do with it is just so funny. You can tell they really embrace the over-the-top comedy potential this movie has, while still keeping the characters interesting. Speaking of characters, I think it was a smart decision to have this movie center around a family, because not only is their dynamic set up at the beginning of the film, but it's also a fun dynamic. While the plot is unfolding, the movie's just letting you watch this family, and it's fun to see how they fit into the plot. That dynamic is shown throughout the entire movie, and it leads to a lot of funny and touching scenes. The plot works well because the characters feel natural, and the movie doesn't shove in a new character every 5 minutes. Well, there are these two robots who help the family, but they are hilarious and plot relevant throughout the entire movie. Yeah, these characters are a ton of fun to watch, and their designs complement their personalities really well. Speaking of which, the animation. This is where most of the Spider-Verse comparison comes from, because this movie looks gorgeous. I love the character designs, the effects, the color palette, the action scenes, the expressions. It's just so beautiful. You can tell the character designs and the way they're animated is a little similar to how they were in Spider-Verse. But what really makes the animation stand out is just all the little details they put in. I'm not talking about things like the textures, although those do look nice. I'm talking about like all this. It's just super fun to see all these details pop up throughout the movie. They fit well with the movie's comedic style, and they give the movie its own flair. The climax especially is full of these, and it's just amazing. The action that utilizes all the robot technology is pretty cool as well. And the high-tech settings like PAL Labs look awesome. Just like Spider-Verse, the creative and innovative animation makes the movie a lot more fun to watch and see all the little details put into it. Another thing I loved about this movie was the voice acting. All the voice actors do a phenomenal job, and they bring a lot of extra personality into these already interesting characters. And finally, while I wouldn't say this movie is some sort of emotional masterpiece, that aspect is strong. Like I said, they did establish the bond between Katie and her dad very well in the first 5 minutes, so it's easy to get interested in. They clearly both don't understand each other, which makes the climax of the movie a lot more interesting. We see them both having to utilize each other's strengths and be a Mitchell. Not only is it pretty funny considering it has some of the running gags in this movie, but it's also sweet. I guess this movie does fit the criteria of the typical be yourself message, but it's executed in a way that makes it feel different enough. Just like the Lego movie, this movie has strong emotions at the center of its very comedic, very energetic, very fast-paced, very enjoyable story. Each scene knows exactly what tone it wants to have, and it makes the movie very engaging. Not only are the characters themselves likable, but the amazing writing and directing help this bizarre story become really great. Overall, I really liked The Mitchells vs. the Machines. It's such a crazy and fun movie that was really entertaining for me. The story is well executed, the comedy is great, the animation is amazing, and the characters are all likable. I'm not really sure if I like this more than Luca, though. Luca definitely had better characters and emotional moments, but I enjoyed this movie's art style and comedy a lot more. Either way, they're both really great movies, and I would recommend going and watching both of them. This movie was a really fun time and would be my second favorite Sony Pictures animation movie. Definitely a movie worth watching. I'm going to give The Mitchells vs. the Machines a 9 out of 10. Thank you all for watching. Like the video if you enjoyed, comment down below, hit that subscribe button if you haven't already, and I'll see you guys next time.